हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर गोविंद नारायण पुरोहित, द फॉर्मर डीन पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट स्टडीज एंड द यूनिवर्सिटी हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ वेटनरी गायनेकोलॉजी एंड ऑब्स्टेट्रिक्स, कॉलेज ऑफ वेटनरी एंड एनिमल साइंसेज, राजस्थान यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ वेटनरी एंड एनिमल साइंसेज, बीकानेर, राजस्थान, इंडिया. फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू टू माई यूट्यूब चैनल गोविंद नारायण पुरोहित, वेयर इन करंटली वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द वेरियस MCQs in teriogenology, and in our today's talk we discuss about the MCQs on Easter synchronization. Friends, if you have already subscribed to my channel, I am highly thankful to you. If you have not already subscribed, kindly do subscribe to it so that you receive the notification of our video lectures very soon. So friends, let us start. So friends, let us discuss about Easter synchronization in our today's video lecture. As you all know that Easter synchronization can be done by has been done for many purposes, for plant matings to save the labor. You can bring the animals into estrus at the same time and you can mate them at the same time. So for plant matings and for plant calvings, if you want to plan your calvings on a particular time, then you have to synchronize estrus by using the various approaches. And then for embryo transfer, of course, the estrus synchronization is a must. You need to synchronize the donors and the recipients for Easter synchronization. So these are the basic purposes of Easter synchronization. Now, before we talk about the various MCQ, let us talk something else. That management is important. Cows must be appropriately managed and they must be well fed before attempt the Easter synchronization. Now, the estrus synchronization protocols usually involve the lysis of the CL, and this brings the animals into estrus, or another is the dominant follicle. The persistence of the dominant follicle prevents the cow to coming into estrus. So ovulating this dominant follicle, or ablating or converting this dominant follicle into or luteinization of this dominant follicle results into the initiation of a new follicular growth wave and cows return to estrus. So this involves the GnRH based protocols or the progesterone based protocols. So this is something very basic, and now we start talking about the various MCQs on Easter synchronization. Now, this one is basically with the estrus detection. When using tail painting for estrus detection in cows, the color of the paint should be changed every 30 days, 45 days, 21 days, and 7 days. As you remember, the cows return to estrus every 21 to 23 days. So, those that have been applied to the paint, the paint should be changed every 21 days. So 21 days is the right answer, right? In dairy herds, the maximum number of cows evidence estrus during 6 a.m. to noon, noon to 6 p.m., 6 p.m. to midnight, and midnight to 6 a.m. Basically, cows evidence estrus during 45%, 43 to 45% of the cows evidence estrus during this time, and then some proportion of cows evidence estrus during this time. So midnight to 6 a.m. that is the right answer, right? Applying chalk to the rump is not a good option for estrus detection in buffaloes because of the black color, because of the heavy body, because of the licking habits, and because of the wallowing habits. You see, Holstein Friesian cows also have a black color. So So black color is not going to affect the application of the chalk. Heavy body, yes, of course, heavy body has nothing to do with application of the chalk. Licking habits are less common in buffaloes, so but wallowing habits are fairly common in buffaloes. Buffaloes love to wallow, and that is why they are known as the water buffalo. So wallowing habits is the right answer, right? Then chin ball markers are applied to the chin of bulls for detection of fighting between bulls, trace the bulls in large herds, stress detection of cows, and easy handling. You see, on the chin of the bull, a chin ball marker is applied because the bull, when it mounts the cow, it presses the back of the cow with his chin. So this is used, and so when this chin ball marker is pressed, the dye is released, and which puts a mark on the back of the cow. So this is used for stress detection in cows, right? Then Kamar and Estrotect are pressure sensitive heat mount detectors, electronic stress detectors, devices to detect excessive salivation of cows, cervical mucus detection devices. You see, Kamar and Estrotect, they are applied to the back of the cow, and when another cow mounts it, due to the pressure in Kamar, some dye is released and which gives a color. Then Estrotect are scratch card type devices which are put on the back of the cow, and when another cow mounts it, then this scratch appears and the color beneath the scratch appears, and so it is we are able to detect the cow is in estrus. So both these devices are pressure sensitive heat mount detectors. So this is the right answer, right? The voluntary waiting period. Now, to initiate the estrus synchronization, there are fixed voluntary waiting periods for cows. Now, the voluntary waiting period is the number of days following cows calving that the cow will not be bred, will not be sold, will not be transported, will not be milked. So, voluntary waiting is the period when cows will not be bred. Even if they return to estrus, then they will not be bred. So that is the right answer, right? If 10 cows are eligible to be bred in a herd over a 21-day period, but only 4 are bred, the heat detection rate is 20%, 40%, 10%, 80%. In spite of all estrus detection aids, the estrus detection rate is not exceeding 70 to 80%. But in this case, because only 4 cows have been bred, so estrus detection rate is 40%. 4 out of 10, so that is 40%, right? The radio telemetric pressure sensitive devices such as heat watch detect estrus in cows by mounting of cows, by the cervicovaginal mucus, by pheromones, by physical activity. You see, radio telemetric devices are something, devices which are put on the back of the cow. As soon as the cow is mounted by another cow or by the bull, then it creates a pressure on that device. This sends signals to the receiver, and that receiver then sends signal to your computer. So it is basically a pressure sensitive device which detects mounting of the cows, right? That is the right answer. Bovinose is a system developed for estrus detection in cows and is based on detection of cows, detection of physical activity of cows, bellowing of cows, pheromones secreted in urine, mounting by herd mates or teaser bull. You see, many pheromones have been detected in the urine of cows, and these pheromones, propionic acid and many others, volatile fatty acids, are detected by the bull. Now, this is a system which detects the volatile fatty acids in the urine of cows. So, this is based on the pheromones secreted in the urine of cows, right? A teaser is a male used for hysteret detection in cows and is usually prepared by surgical vasectomy, epididymectomy, orchidectomy, tenellectomy. You see, cutting the vas deferens, so that is known as vasectomy. So they are vasectomized males, right? An average cow during estrus is mounted how many times during estrus? You see, an average cow remains in estrus for 12 to 18 hours. And during this period, the cow is mounted by herd mates and many a times by the herd mates. So, 25 to 30 times. So, 30 times is the right answer, right? One teaser bull is sufficient for estrus detection for how many cows in a herd? You see, in a dairy, 5 to 10, 10 to 20, 30 to 50, 50 to 100. One bull is sufficient for how many cows for breeding? That the same will be applicable for the teaser bull. It is mentioned that for the age of the heifer, a bull's age would decide the number of heifers it is sufficient, starting from 1 month to a maximum of 30 months. So, a bull of 30 months age can detect 30 cows in estrus. So, 30 to 50 is the right answer, right? For estrus detection in thoroughbred mares, they must be teased using a stallion or pony every 12 hours, 24 hours, 48 hours, 72 hours. You see, if you remember in our lecture, that mares are teased daily morning and evening, starting every day, daily morning and evening. And the records are maintained for thoroughbred mares starting from the breeding season till the end of the breeding season for every day. So, the mares are teased every 12 hours, right? Applying wet paint or grease on the chest of a male is a common method of estrus detection in cows, buffaloes, dogs, sheep. You see, applying grease on the ram's chest is a common method of estrus detection in sheep. So, sheep is the right answer, right? Applying an apron to cover the penis is a common method of estrus detection in cattle and buffalo, sheep and goats, males and donkeys, pigs and cats. Use of apronized males for estrus detection is common in sheep and goats. So, that is the right answer, right? Applying pressure on the back to see if the animal stands rigidly is a common method to detect estrus in pigs, right? That is the right answer. It is easier to detect forthcoming estrus in a bitch due to strong barking, pro-estrus bleeding, frequent urination, altered behavior. A bitch in estrus has a pro-estrus period of 7 to 9 days. So, it is easier that the bitch will now be in estrus by the pro-estrus bleeding, right? Breeding bucks have an unpleasant musky odor. It's difficult to go near a breeding buck, and that musky odor originates from secretion from scent glands between horns and self and urination, secretion of high amounts of androgens from testes, secretion of androstenone in saliva, habit of buck to lie in corners. No, a breeding buck has got a habit of self and urination. It sprays the urine on its own body, and even sometimes it just licks it. So secretion of scent glands between horns and self anurination, that provides the very typical odor to the breeding buck. A pheromone like molecule found in the boar saliva and fat that induces estrus in weaned sows is propionic acid, androstenone, acetic acid, 4-ethyl branch fatty acids. So it is androstenone, right? Estrus synchronization can reduce the intercalving interval in cattle. This is statement one. And prostaglandins can be used to prolong the luteal phase of cattle. Both statement A and statement B are correct. Statement A is correct, but statement B is incorrect. Statement A is incorrect, but statement B is correct. Both statement A and statement B are incorrect. You see, the estrus synchronization, of course, can reduce the intercalving intervals in cattle. And so this statement is correct. Prostaglandins can be used to prolong the luteal phase of the cattle. No, prostaglandins are used to cut short the luteal phase of cattle. So this statement is wrong. So the correct answer is statement A is correct, but statement B is incorrect, right? Two-dose prostaglandin F2-alpha can be used to synchronize estrus in cyclic non-pregnant cows. Yes, the window of response for prostaglandin F2-alpha in cows is 5 to 15 days of estrus cycling. This is also correct. So both statement A and statement B are correct. This is the right answer. Right? The success rate in estrus synchronization programs in cattle depends on body weight of cows, management and use of high fertility semen, watering of cows and transport of cows. You see, the very first requirement is proper management and feeding and use of high fertility semen. So this is the right answer, right? Some estrus cows do not respond to prostaglandin F2-alpha because cows are unhealthy, there is no CL, cows are not given arachidonic acid, cows are fed legumes. You see, the action of prostaglandin F2-alpha is on the CL. So if there is no CL, the anestrus cow will not come into estrus. So that is the right answer, right? The disadvantage of oral feeding of melangestrol acetate to heifers for estrus synchronization is the prolongation of the estrus, formation of persistent follicles, lysis of the CL, development of bull-like behavior. You see, with oral feeding for 7 to 11 days, there is sometimes formation of persistent follicles in heifers. So this is the right answer, right? Which of the following is not a GnRH based estrus synchronization protocol for cows? Oosing, selecting, oosing and CIDRP. You see, with oosing, we use GnRH, PG GnRH, same with these two. So CIDRP is a progesterone containing vaginal implant. So this is not a GnRH based protocol. So this is the right answer, right? Vaginal implants impregnated with fluorogestone acetate and methyl acetoxyprogesterone followed by ECG are commonly employed for estrus synchronization in cattle, mares, buffalo, sheep. You see, for sheep and goat, the FGA, fluorogestone acetate, and the MGA, they are commonly used vaginal implants, and they are used for estrus synchronization in sheep and goat. So sheep is the correct answer, right? A 60 watt bulb is lit in the stables of thoroughbred mares in the months of December and January to initiate estrus. The estrus cycle of mares during the transition period are very erratic and irregular. The answer is both statements A and B are correct. Statement A is correct, but statement B is incorrect. Statement A is incorrect, but statement B is correct. Both statement A and B are incorrect. Yes, 60 watt bulb is lit in the stables during the months of December to initiate estrus early. And the estrus cycle of males during the transition period are very erratic. So, during this transition period, to avoid the irregularities of estrus cycle or to phase shift, prepone the irregular cycles, the cycles are started in January. So that in January, the estrus cycles will be erratic. But in February, when the breeding season starts, the cycles will be regular. So both the statements are correct and this is the right answer. Both statement A and statement B are correct. Right? So this is the next question. Estrus can be induced in anestrus mares by oral administration of domperidone, cabergoline, albendazole, amphetamine. You see, estrus can be induced by prolactinemic drug. So, domperidone is one, cabergoline is anti-prolactin, albendazole is anti-helminthic. So, the domperidone is the right answer. Right? In the O-SYNC protocol, the following is the sequence of administration of hormones. PG, GnRH, PG, GnRH, PG, GnRH, PG, GnRH, GnRH, PG, estradiol, PG, estradiol, GnRH. GPG protocol, O-SYNC protocol is also known as the GPG protocol. So, this is the right answer, right? In the O-SYNC protocol for estrus synchronization, the GnRH, PG and GnRH are administered on 07 and 9 days, 05 and 7 days, 09 and 14 days, 07 and 03 and 7 days. 0, 7 and 9 days. This is the right answer, right? The O-SYNC protocol for estrus synchronization was developed by Opsoner and Associates, Persley and Associates, Wildbank and Associates, and Ohuraja and Associates. You see, it was Persley who was working with Derrick House and he developed this protocol. So, that is the right answer, Persley and Associates, right? In the 7-11 sync estrus synchronization for beef cows, O-sync is combined with oral feeding of malangestrol acetate, sodium propionate, clomiphene citrate, sodium acid phosphate. Malangestrol acetate is fed and then the O-sync protocol GPG is followed. So, malangestrol acetate oral feeding is the right answer, right? In the O-SYNC protocol for estrus synchronization, timed insemination is done after how many hours of PG injection? 24 hours, 48 hours, 96 hours, 60 hours. You see, after PG injection, 60 to 72 hours is the right answer, right? The O-SYNC estrus synchronization protocol, O-SYNC for cows has the advantage that conception rates are high, estrus detection is not required, lesser number of injections are required, cows bellow loudly. So, estrus detection is not required, right? That is the right answer. Which of the below mentioned estrus synchronization protocol for cows does not use fixed time insemination? You see, O-SYNC uses fixed time insemination. MGS Select use fixed time insemination. 7-11 Select Sync uses fixed time insemination. But in select sync, the GnRH, PG and GnRH are given, but it is dependent on the estrus detection and not fixed time insemination. So select sync is the right answer, right? Which of the following estrus synchronization treatments are more useful in the buffalo during the non-breeding season? Hosing, select sync, resistant treatments combined with PG and ECG, co-sync. You see, during the non-breeding season, progesterone in vaginal implants are considered more beneficial for buffalo, right? In double PG estrus synchronization programs for dairy cows, fixed time insemination is done at 24 to 48 hours, 60 to 72 hours, 72 to 96 hours. And 12 to 24 hours. See, cows usually return within 48 hours. So, fixed time insemination is done at 60 to 72 hours, right? In the heat sink protocol for estrus synchronization of dairy cows, the second dose of GnRH is replaced with, in heat sink, the second dose is replaced with estradiol, right? That is the right answer. A majority of lactating sows return to estrus within 10 days of culling, overexposure, weaning, ECG treatment. You see, just after weaning, sows return to estrus. So, weaning is the right answer, right? A high proportion of gilts of 160 to 180 days exhibit estrus within 28 days of estradiol injection, prostaglandin injection, overexposure, progesterone injection. Boar exposure brings a high proportion of gilts to estrus. So, boar exposure is the right answer, right? Allitranbolone can be fed to sows and gilts at the dose rate of 10 to 15 mg per animal for 18 days to maintain pregnancy, treat ovarian cysts, induce estrus and terminate pregnancy. You see, allitranbolone is a progesterone derivative. So, it is used for inducing estrus, not to terminate the pregnancy, neither to maintain pregnancy, nor to treat ovarian cysts, right? Prostaglandins are only effective in inducing estrus during the breeding season in cows, buffaloes, pigs and goats. You see, in sheep and goat, PGs are not effective during the non-breeding season. So, goat is the right answer, right? Phase shifting of reproduction can be done in sheep by subcutaneous administration of commercial implants of GnRH, estradiol, melatonin and progestins. You see, Mallowin is one implant which is commercially available and this is used to phase shift reproduction in sheep and this contains melatonin, right? Androvax and Ovastim used for increasing fecundity of sheep is not recommended for use in Magra ewes, Rambouillet ewes, Romanov ewes and Merino ewes. It is not recommended for Merino ewes, right? Androvax and Ovastim increase ovulations in sheep by increasing the estrogen, LH, progesterone and FSH. Androvax and Ovastim block ovulation for a certain time period and after that the GnRH secretion is increased. So, this leads to increased secretion of luteinizing hormone, right? So, that increases the ovulatory rates in sheep, right? And thus the fecundity. Androvax and Ovastim used for increasing fecundity in sheep contain estradiol, androstenedione, FSH and progesterone. They contain androstenedione, right? That is the right answer. Now, this is a match the following answer. So, you have to match them carefully. Garol sheep is known for its high prolificacy. Co-sync is a estrus synchronization protocol. GnRH is secreted from the hypothalamus and cabergolin is used for any stress in pitch. So 1C, 2D, 2D, 3A, 4B. So this is the right answer, right? Estrus synchronization in cattle can be done principally using three hormones, PG, progesterone and GnRH. The hormones used cause either the demise of the CL or the dominant follicle, which stimulates a new follicular wave. Statement A is correct and statement B is the correct explanation of statement A. Statement A is correct, but statement B is not the correct explanation of statement A. Statement A is incorrect, but statement B is correct. Both statement A and B are incorrect. You see, the hormones, they cause either the demise of the CL or the dominant follicle, which stimulates a new follicular growth wave. So both the statements are right. So number one, statement A is correct and statement B is the correct explanation of statement A. This is the right answer, right? Two kinds of progesterone-like products for synchronization are melangestrol acetate and prostaglandins, melangestrol acetate and CIDR vaginal insert, CIDRB and estrumate, estradiol benzoate and prostaglandins. You see, prostaglandins are not progesterone like. CIDR and estrumate are also, estrumate is not progesterone like compound, and prostaglandins are also not progesterone-like compound. So the right answer is MGA, oral progesterone, and CIDR, vaginal insert. They all, both contain progesterone-like compounds, right? So that is the right answer. Melangestrol acetate is a feed additive that blocks females from cycling, an injectable form of progesterone, too expensive to consider as part of a synchronization protocol, will never induce non-cycling cows or heifers to start cycling. It is a feed additive which blocks the heifers from cycling. But afterwards, when you stop it, then heifers start cycling. So that way it is used for estrus synchronization, oral feeding. CIDR vaginal inserts can be left in during estrus and breeding, must be removed to allow the heifer or cow to cycle, are the least expensive synchronization product, release GnRH through the vaginal wall and into the bloodstream. They do not release GnRH, they release progesterone. They are not least expensive. They cannot be left during estrus because that will prevent breeding. So they must be removed to allow the heifer or cow to cycle. That is the right answer, right? Prostaglandins are used in estrus synchronization protocols to cause regression of the CL, to prevent estrus and ovulation, to terminate a follicular wave, to trigger ovulation. This is very simple. They are used to cause regression of the CL, right? So friends, if you like these videos, kindly give your suggestions, kindly give your comments and give your likes. And kindly share and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Govind Narayan Purohit. You can contact me at my email, gnpobs@gmail.com. If you have any queries, if you have any doubts, I will be more than happy to help you out. And you can contact me at my email. So, I hope these would be useful and you will enjoy your preparations. Best of luck to all of you. Bye-bye.